Now I'm going to show you how you can use this DS0138 oscilloscope. So the input is connected to function generator now with the sinusoidal wave that I have. And then here, this is for AC, DC and ground coupling. So when you ground it, the input will be grounded. This input will be connected to the ground. And if I go, now this is AC, it shows here. If I go DC, the signal, if it's shifted, it goes to the original position with respect to zero. So AC will bring it back from the same point up and down, so it will be at the middle that you will see it. Then this is the sensitivity. This side is, which is written here, 10 millivolts, and then at the middle is 100 millivolts, so this becomes 10 times smaller displayed, and then 1 volt, again 10 times more, so 10 times 100 is 1 volt, so this is how it is shown. So I'm going to put it back, and this is the scaling. By the way, when you move that, you will see it here also, it displays. No, yeah, it shows. So this is defective. Maybe I soldered it incorrectly or something. This should have been 100 millivolts. Okay, so the last one is working. And then this portion is not working. And then this one is scaling this one. Times 1 mean exactly what you see. Times 2 mean twice smaller. And times 5 mean 5 times smaller, whatever is the signal. So whatever you read, make sure that you see this is being multiplied, it shows, and change it accordingly. So this is 10 millivolts, but if I go to 5 times smaller, it shows 50 millivolts each division. So that is done. These 4 switches are for different purpose. So this is for selecting or holding. So anytime you just press hold, it will just hold the signal and it will stay even if I disconnect it. So the signal is there, so you can read it. To release it back, just press it. It will go back to running. And then this square around this value is time base. It shows each square wave is supposed to be 50 microseconds. This shows as U incorrect, but that is referring to micro, because maybe this cannot show the micro. So when the square is here, these two buttons are up and down are ready to function. So 50 microseconds, see, 20 microseconds, 10 microseconds, the maximum that we can go, or lower, it goes 1 millisecond, so each division will increase and decrease, so you can see the waveform. To move it to the next one, we press this button, it moves to the next. This is a triggering mode. So when you set it on auto, auto means regardless of the trigger level happens or not, the signal is displayed. Because sometimes you need to see a certain level of signal to be displayed, so you set the trigger level, but now it's auto, regardless it is displayed. Now if I press this up, it goes to normal. So when the trigger level happened, it will display, otherwise it will not. And then signal means when the signal triggers happen, it just stays there and goes to hold. So the signal triggered it. Now it's on hold, you cannot exit. To exit back, you have to make sure with these two buttons, make this normal, and then press this so you can exit. Now I'm pressing this. This is a for rising edge. Let's go back to the square wave. So this is for rising edge. Now the trigger happens when each waveform goes up, the trigger happens and the waveform is viewed. Now this also can be changed with these two. I'm going down, that's falling edge, and rising edge, the shape also changes. So after this, I'm pressing this and cursor move, this is now green. Now this is for the trigger level, so you can change it to see at what level it can trigger. because this is normal. I'm pressing it. It comes down, 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 down. Now, if I press this again, now the square waved and gone here now, the color. Now we can slide the signal left and right. And this shows that we are on the right side of the signal. I'm holding this and make sure you pay attention that portion is coming to the left. So now if I press this again, the cursor will move here. This is for vertical shift of the signal. Now when I move this again, it comes back to time base. Now to see the data about this waveform, just press and hold this. You see the data and it starts hold, but if you want to see live value, just press this and all the value will be live. For example, I can change the amplitude and you can see it, 27 millivolts, it changes to 17 and then 8 and so forth. So to exit back, press and hold it. It exits, but it goes to hold and press it once more and it will exit. That's it. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, please share it, and also please subscribe.